Last month, California became the second state in the nation to allow specially treated wastewater to be used for drinking and other household needs. Which brings to mind a recycling effort underway in Vermont that we admit defies easy description. Faith Salie on job number one.
Here's Lissa Schneckenberger performing for us and for the plants in her Brattleboro, Vermont garden. The tomatoes seem happy, so do the bees. And this may be the reason why. Here is Lissa enriching the garden with her own family's urine.
When we tell people about it, they're mostly confused. They're just like, what, why, what?
Welcome to the world of pea cycling, where urine is not considered waste, but liquid gold.
If you meet someone new and they say, what do? How do you answer?
Yeah. I say I work at an organization that's developing ways to turn human urine into fertilizer.
That organization is called the Rich Earth Institute, and Abe Noe Hayes is its co-founder, along with Kim Nace.
People are usually a little taken back, but then I just kind of, I give them the real quick, there's nutrients in your urine, and we are figuring out how to capture those and use them in agriculture.
How many pee jokes do you deal with on a daily basis?
Pee jokes are constant.
But to Nace and Noe Hayes, the concept of saving and reusing human urine is a serious endeavor.
So what is in urine that plants need?
Nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, and other trace minerals that come through our body as we eat our food and then use the toilet.
How much urine are you collecting at this point?
About 12,000 gallons a year.
Researchers around the U.S. and the world are studying urine recycling in Sweden, in Switzerland, in France, and in South Africa and other countries. And the Rich Earth Institute regularly offers educational webinars.
What do you think would surprise people the most?
That it is clean, that it doesn't look gross, and it doesn't smell. And the privacy thing, too. That was a surprise to me. It's totally quiet.
So there's no flush.
There's no flush.
That's because Lissa Schneckenberger uses a very special toilet with two compartments.
Toilet paper and solid waste go in the back, and then urine goes in the front. So there's two compartments. Both go into separate compartments downstairs in these collection tanks. Rich Earth comes with a big truck and a big hose, and they empty the urine tank twice a year.
How much urine have you saved?
It's a lot.
And if you don't happen to have a special toilet, the Rich Earth Institute offers this low-tech portable urinal.
Now, would only a man use this?
No, men can use it, but women can also squat over this.
Rich Earth also makes it easy for donors to deliver their liquid waste to a downtown depot. As you can see, the process requires no pouring.
I think it's pretty great.
Kevin O'Brien is a community tool librarian who's been bringing his urine here for 3 years.
For me, it takes me about a month to fill up a 5-gallon jug. So I'm kind of come to the depot about once a month to donate, although I want to reach towards a goal of donating 100 gallons a year.
Those who do receive a lovely certificate from Rich Earth.
So the urine comes in, goes through this system.
Urine is typically free of harmful bacteria, but if it gets near solid waste, that could lead to disease. So Abe Noe Hayes says that all of the urine that Rich Earth collects is pasteurized to federal standards.
It's clean?
Yeah, it's heated up, pathogens die, it cools back down, and then it leaves the machine.
And then Arthur Davis transfers the clean urine from the huge storage tanks to his truck's containers, around 1,000 gallons at a time.
It's actually about 4 tons.
On his big yellow truck with the custom license plate, Davis oversees the entire collection and distribution process.
We're dealing with chemistry, we're dealing with biology, we're also dealing with psychology of people, because people have all kinds of thoughts about it.
Ready for ya.
Today, he's delivering to a true believer, Noah Hoskins, owner of the Bunker Farm. Hoskins says his grazing fields are thirsty for pee.
If you are taking nutrients out of the ground, you need to be replenishing those nutrients in some form or another.
A lot of pea cycling is still in the research and development phase.
A pH of 4.66.
But Kim Nace and Abe Noe-Hayes imagine a bright yellow future.
You're kind of asking for a cultural change.
We're not asking people to do something this difficult. You just use the toilet. That thing you just did, that was great. You know, that you made something useful and you made something that's going to do good in the world. You're like, oh, really? I did? Oh, yeah.